Hey, what is going on, you guys? It is Mr. No Sleep here from Old School RuneScape, and welcome to a brand new video for you all today. Today, I bring you guys another Wilderness Boss related loot video, loot from 1,000 crazy archaeologists found in 24 Wilderness. I would say this is one of the most unpopulated areas of the wild as it pertains to a Wilderness Boss, you know, compared to Venonatus, compared to Vedion, and compared to Callisto, as well as Chaos Elemental. I would say this one is the most safest of them all, as it goes for the amount of PKers, so there's not too much anti-PKing in this video as there usually is. However, I do have some pretty awesome clips for you guys later on in the video, so I do hope you guys enjoy, and with all of that being said, let's get into it. So there is quite a few different methods that you can use in order to kill the crazy archaeologist. The main method that I was using this whole entire video from start to finish was essentially using my player-owned house to rejuvenate my special attack, and every single kill I was just using 4 specials. At first, I was using 4 Dragon Dagger specials, then I tried out Dragon Claws and a Dragon Dagger, and then finally I decided that the best method was using a Dragon Warhammer spec, followed by 2 Dragon Dagger specs, and then of course finishing off the kill with a Vigora's Chain Mace, because as we all know, the Kraw's Bow and the Vigora's Chain Mace are the 2 best in-slot weapons in the wilderness on most monsters, and as you can see at the very beginning of the video, I was using a whip because, you know, just kind of wanted to try it out. Obviously, if you use the Vigora's Chain Mace and the House Teleport method, you will be spending a decent amount of money on the ether, and of course the teleport to get back here, which is pretty much on the ancient spellbook. Now, if you use the runes on the ancient spellbook to teleport to this area in the wilderness, which is virtually like 10 steps away from where this crazy archaeologist is, then you're gonna save a lot of money. However, since I wanted to maximize the amount of kills per hour, I decided that it was better for me to use Vengeance on the lunar spellbook and just use the teleport tabs to get me back to this location after every single kill. And if you're curious what the teleport name is to get to this location, I think it is pronounced Deryak or Deryak. But yeah, that is a teleport tablet that's currently worth about 6k. So I did have to spend just over 6 mil in order to kill 1,000, since I was teleporting to my house after every single kill, and then of course getting my special attack and teleporting right back up. So yeah, a lot of money was spent, you know, supplies do add up over time, but at the same time, if you want to maximize your kills per hour, you just got to do what you got to do. So I wasn't too concerned about the money lost. I knew we were going to profit during this video. You know, a lot of people underestimate this crazy archaeologist. It's kind of known as the Iron Man boss, you know, the thing that you kill on your Iron Man account when you want to unlock a rune crossbow early on. At least that's what I did on my Iron Man many years ago. The crazy archaeologist was released into the game March 13th, 2014, and although it is 204 combat, it's only 225 HP. All of these small little fences around this area you can use to your advantage, and if you keep your distance using magic and you pray range and avoid the explosion attack that he does have quite often, then you will virtually never take damage and you can stay here for a very, very long time. We did start this video at just about 60 KC, so we would end it at 1060, and as you can see, you know, the top tier drops being the Malediction Shard 2 as well as the Odium Shard 2, and we were seeing quite a lot of that early on. You know, we had some really good luck, which I was very thankful for. You know, didn't really know how to feel coming into this video, but yeah, seeing 2 Malediction Shards so early on really gave me that motivation that at least told me that I was going to make some profit. And although you may say, well, you know, the Malediction Shard's only 900k, it's not that much, just wait until the end of the video, because something actually happened that did surprise me, so the price check might surprise you. We'll see. Moving on though, you know, as I mentioned, the Odium Shard 2 is dropped, and we did receive that just before the 250th kill, so it was really nice to see. Just adds on to the luck, followed by the infamous Fedora after that, which is considered a rare, but it's only worth like 3k. And a few kills after that, I did receive a really rare drop, which I believe is, according to the wiki, 1 in 8,000 or 1 in 1,000. I'm not too sure of the details, but Shield Left Half, you know, quite the item to see from this monster. I don't know, it was pretty strange. And of course, 2 untradeable items that I did see quite a bit of would be the Longbone, which gives you a lot of construction XP if you collect them over time, and of course the Clue Scroll. They do actually drop hard clues, and the drop rate on the hard clues is 1 in 128. If you decide to use a Ring of Wealth imbued, that will actually drop down to 1 in 64, so if you just want to get some more clues, keep that in mind. Did of course do every Clue Scroll during this video, and we saved all of them towards the end, and all the Longbone Strong Bones that we did collect, which is a 1 and 64 drop as well. We did save towards the end, started at about 13 from the beginning of the video, and they did stack up quite nicely for a lot of construction XP. And here we are with another Odium Shard 2. Actually did go up in price during the making of this video because it took about 2 weeks to complete since this one was kind of on and off. So yeah, that was nice to see. It's going to add nice to the price check, and at this point we had 5 hard clue scroll caskets as well. And if you are curious as to why I decided to not use magic, just kind of go with the melee method. I know some people always say magic is best in slot here, and that is true. I also had a lot of people curious as to why I did not use bounty hunter worlds to kill this, because I would have received a lot of emblems. Essentially, your answer is, well, I was using all of my special attacks on this crazy archaeologist, so that would have made the anti-PKing very difficult. And as I mentioned earlier, you know, there isn't too many PKers here, but if you happen to run into one, just one, my risk during this whole video was over 8 mil, so it's a lot of money to lose. I did have my void protected as soon as I switched to it. However, this clip here kind of shows you a good example of why I didn't want to risk even more by bringing magic. And you always have to be very careful because, you know, the amount of brews and the amount of food you use isn't just for the crazy archaeologist. This is a PKing hotspot for certain levels. Not so much my level, but you never know who's wandering out there, especially when you're live streaming this all on Twitch. But thank God for the Twitch chat. Two of my greatest friends came, who both had 2200 total level, because I was screaming like a little girl for someone to save me, and they did. So shout out to those guys. I guess that's just luck on my part that they had a high total. One of them was doing Nightmare Zone, the other one was doing Zolcano, and they rushed here as quickly as they could, and they did save my 8 mil. So big shout out to them. Really do appreciate it. And that is just a subtle reminder that you never know what to expect. This is the wilderness after all, and although there's a lot of rats here, and although the crazy archaeologist can actually interrupt your fight and maybe save your life if someone jumps on you, you still can never be too careful. So that's kind of why I just wanted to go with the basic melee setup and bank after every single kill, minimize the risk, and maximize the kills per hour. So here we are with another Malediction Shard 2, and alongside that we did get a Rune Square Shield, which is 1 and 2,000, as well as a Rune Battle Axe, which is 1 and 1,300. So yeah, pretty odd rare drop table, but I'm pretty sure that's with a lot of monsters in this game, not just the crazy archaeologist. And we can't forget about the normal drop table of this monster, you know, the Rune Crossbows, the Red Dehide Bodies, the Rune Knives, you know, pretty good ammunition, as well as the Cannonballs and the Dragon Arrows. Drops a little bit of food, you know, sharks, potatoes with cheeses, anchovy pizzas, Prayer Potion 4s. This was definitely the highlight of the video drop-wise, receiving an Odium Shard 2, and in the same kill getting another Hard Clue Scroll, two of my favorite things to see in this video. I will say the Odium Shard 2, despite the price in the chat, is not more than the Malediction Shard 2, so don't get it confused. Really depends on the supply and demand. You know, not many people kill this monster who aren't an Iron Man, so therefore there's less Malediction Shard 2s and less Odium Shard 2s in the game versus the other components. So that is something that I found pretty interesting. You know, a lot more people kill Scorpia on a main, you know, pet hunting and whatnot, and of course Chaos Fanatic, and you get those shards from those two monsters as well. However, there's no pet that is attached to the crazy archaeologist, so unfortunately, you know, he is all alone south of the Forgotten Cemetery, and not many mains kill him. And speaking of being killed, I just want to give a shout out to this Iron Man who did make an attempt on my life, and he failed dramatically, but at least he went out in fashion. So yeah, shout out to you, sir. Dragon Warhammer is always more powerful than the Dragon Medhelm, so thank you for that. Shortly after that, speaking of death, I did receive 45 death runes, which is a 1 in 2048 drop. So yeah, there was RNG all over the place here. I mean, I really think they should add a pet, you know, pet crazy archaeologist, small little thing that just follows you around and screams at you all the time. That would be lovely. And for all of those who do really want to see magic used on this boss, I did go ahead and get my Sang Staff out, as well as Max Mage, and I did go ahead and try my best to do a few kills with it. It worked really well, as expected. I kept my distance, I received no damage, and, you know, the kills were slower. However, it was just much more easier, and if you use Fire Surge, you'll even get quicker kills, so something to keep in mind, all about preference, but just wanted to try that out myself. And I'm sure someone was wondering if I died during the making of this video, and out of the 6 attempts that people tried to kill me, I only died one time, and that was by the actual crazy archaeologist, not a PKer, so go figure, this guy killed me at the very end, but it is what it is. Anyways, here we are, starting at kill 60, ending at 1060, 1000 crazy archaeologist was completed, 9 clue scrolls overall, 7 fedoras, 4 odium shards, and 4 malediction shards. It is important to note that these shards are 1 in 256, so my RNG was pretty good during the making this video, no doubt about it. At the very first price check, all of the normal drops, the rune crossbows, all those lovely onyx bolt tips, chips, the cannonballs, and everything included, does come out to be a pretty substantial number, 8.4 mil. And, you know, we will move on to the second price check. Obviously, a huge amount of rusty swords and long bones, just about 16 long bones overall from the 29 there. And that will grant us a lot of construction XP, so looking forward to that. Now, here we are with the second price check, everything included coming out to be just about 8.5 mil. But although we will add this on the calculator and receive 16.9 mil roughly from 1,000 crazy archaeologists, that is just the street price. You know, that's not the actual price. So we're going to get to the actual number here in a little bit. Because like I did mention in the beginning of the video, I was surprised when I sold those shards in the GE. But now we have to go ahead and open all of the hard clue scrolls that we did receive. So let's go ahead and do that. Alongside the untradeable clue scrolls, we did receive all of these rusty swords, which I might actually make into a video in the future, but I don't know. It probably wouldn't be the most interesting thing. Let me know in the comments below what you think. Yeah, you know, opening these clue scrolls, the first one, 38k, not too great. Second one, Zamrock, full helm, and the master. Didn't do the master because, you know, I suck. That was overall 246k, 200k from the next one, and pretty above average clues overall. I don't want to spoil anything, but I did receive third age in the next casket. The real question is, what third age item was it though? You know, I'm just kidding. I wish I did though. But yeah, I got a lot of rune sets, 171 followed by 149, Ceridoman kite shield alongside that Zamrock full helm. Really fashionscaping it up for the free-to-play worlds. You know, if we ever end up doing a free-to-play build with a free-to-play PVM loot video, I've had a few suggestions of that. And I just want to touch on the fact that, yes, I didn't really get anything exotic from these clues, but 1.2 to 1.3 mil, not terrible. You know, anything adds up for the price check, so I'll take it. We did go ahead and turn in all of these long bones. I turned in pretty much a full inventory worth, but divide that by 2, and that's about how much construction XP we did receive, so give or take 65 to 70k from all the long bones, which is just extra, you know, icing on the cake. It's very nice to see. And as promised, here is the part that did surprise me the most. You know, I had all of these malediction shards in the grand exchange for just about 945k apiece, and looking at the grand exchange history, they did sell for over 2 mil each, and those odium shards that were valued at 900k all sold for 1.2 mil. And again, I don't know too much about how prices fluctuate in this game with certain items, but as I said in my theory before, I just think that this boss is very underrated, so that's why those shield components are worth so much more than expected, because there's just not too many in the game. If I'm wrong, just let me know in the comments below. Maybe someone's merching them right now, I have no idea. Either way, you know, the 17 mil that we did make from this video with the clue scrolls and the extra money from the shields now goes to 24.1 mil from 1,000 crazy archaeologists. Don't mind these clips, I just decided to dress up as the crazy archaeologist and kill some people in the Rev Caves, so for all my PKers out there, this is for you. But either way, minusing the cost of supplies, I'm sure a lot of people are curious, how much money did I spend on this video? Well, overall, I spent just about 6.5 mil on teleports, house, and the actual teleport to get to the location. Overall, I spent just about another 2 mil in ether, and in the food and the potions, let's just call it another 1 mil. So from 24 mil profit to 14.6 mil profit. That's still a lot more than I expected to make, so there you guys have it. 14.6 mil is the overall profit that I received from 1,000 crazy archaeologists. For all you Iron Men out there, you guys got a good gist of the rune crossbow drop rate from the bank tab itself, hopefully, and, you know, a good idea of all of the normal, all the common drops that you can expect as well if you decide to camp or kill this boss. Of course, you can make more if you're in a BH world, but expect to be attacked all the time, so just something to keep in mind there. Averaging about 50 kills per hour, you know, it wasn't too bad, only took about 20 hours total. Sorry it took so long to get out there, you know, certain videos I enjoy more than others. Worst case, I just take a break on one and start on another, so yeah, and I do appreciate all the feedback you guys gave me on the lower level idea to kill lower level monsters on a lower combat account. I will get to that very soon, you have my word. With all that being said, thank you guys very much for watching the video, and I will see you guys in a few days with a new one, and until then, Mr. No Sleep, out.